I'm not yet in another graveyard, but I've done this. Where did you see this church? This is one Gothic church, this. Somewhere outside the Bedder, this graveyard is, and it's absolutely huge, massive. The biggest one, I think it's in the Manchester, this graveyard, in the church. I think it's 15th century, this church. All blocked off. Absolutely thousands and thousands of graves. I think it's over 3 miles each way, full of graves. 3 miles each way. That is one big graveyard. Let's go and have a look around. Let's check this one out. I am on the bike. Today, I wonder if you're doing a spirit box in here. I bet there'd be some, you know, really good activity. You know what I mean? People in the day, you know, size of this grave, it's absolutely massive. This grave, imagine how much that would cost back in 1860. Now he's been dead a long time, hasn't he? 1795, died on 25th, January 1860. Okay, now, 17th century. Imagine how much that would cost back in the 17th century. This grave. Thousands. He must have been a very rich man, this guy. Oh, Elizabeth. 1842, died. Arcade the 10th, 1906. See what I mean? You got some proper millionaires living in this graveyard. Proper serious millionaires, man. Also, of Fanny. Fanny, don't imagine her name called Fanny. Sally, wife of John Wood. The above and the beloved. Also, Fanny. No, funny daughter. Imagine going to you, meeting a girl at school and says, I'm taking your daughter out, what's her name, Fanny? Fucking hell. Bobby's got a fucking big Fanny. John wife, ain't man? You got so many people in here, man, have got some serious money back in the day. Proper serious money. You know, like that one there. Probably it's really fucking. All the other ones, all the poor people, have to, you know, a little farting grave like that one there. Little ones, but people back in the 18th century, 17th century, proper serious money in the bank. You know what I mean? When they passed away. And, you know, and then crap one with the crown pop with the thing on it. Man, you've not come alive overnight. You know what I mean? There you are, guys, cutting the grass. You know what I mean? It's fucking, it's something what you do, you know. Like this one, like this grave coming up. That one. That big tombstone. Imagine having the money to do this. Money to do that. It's like better there. 17th century. 16th century graveyard this is. Some people better than here. Telling you. Really freaking good. I think it's where the... No, that's in Cornwall, that. The plague. Where all the plague is. Hey, Mark. Come to Manchester and look at this graveyard. You'd be surprised how big it is. Let me get some really good activity here. You know? Look at that, I'll come up with a curtain. We're coming up to this one now. Right. It must have been over £1 million. This one. Imagine having the money to do this. Imagine if you died back in the day. When was it? When it was a... James Hassel. Imagine when you died in 1813. And then, you know, imagine you died in 1813 and then affording something like that back in that day. You're talking about over £1 million. In today's money, it'd be £6 million. Imagine died and getting buried in something like that. I want that gravestone. It's over £1 million though, I'll have it. Elizabeth, they all called Elizabeth.
Going.
Huh? Anna Grammer. Born 50 to 5942, died 4th of 6, 2014. Couple of grand. David Evans. Also had a couple of grand. To get embedded in a thing like this, you know what I mean? We're not talking, you know, like a little gravestone for about fucking 300-400 quid. Can't knock off about fucking about five or six grand. Something like that. Imagine there though. Like me coming in when it's Halloween, me coming to this graveyard while filming with the night camera, and then I see one of the bodies. I see one of the bodies, you know, coming up from the grave there. I'll be out. If I done a spirit box investigation in here, right, and then and you seen one of the skeletons from 1716, one of the bodies or somewhere, and I'd say to him, what did you die of? You know, probably said starve or something. I was hungry. We didn't get nothing to eat back in the 17th century. You know what I mean? It was all fever and everything, nicking everything. You know what I mean? They get about half a pea or something like that to last them 4 months or something like that. You know what I mean? So it's, you know, and so I would ask them, what did you die of? And they'd probably say heart attack or starvation. You know what I mean? Let's have a look down here. You can easily get lost in this fucking graveyard. It's that big and you can easily get lost in it. You know what I mean? Big graveyard. Looking big one. Thank you. How come they've chopped all the trees down? Afternoon. What I see? An ash. James Walker. Someone's ashes. Funeral day, Chapel Coon. So the of Essex. Cemetery remains of the late Stephen Walker. Someone scattered his ashes along there. Oh, come on. I wouldn't like to get burned by that guy in that tub. Probably the cheapest way. Probably they can't afford the burial, so they burn you, they scatter your ashes. That's the thing I've come across, that bamboo. They use that in China. I come across an urn with someone's ashes in it. I might put a lottery on in a bit. I don't know. That one there. Noventra. Ah, talk about this one. He died a month later. We've got this one. Is it the Muslim one? I'm in the Muslim one. I'm in the Muslim one, graveyard part. Never knew they had a Muslim one. Muslim graveyard here. That's a bit good, isn't it? Look. The gates of heaven. The big doors. With the gates open when you've had your time. He was a sailor, Patrick Tanner. what you got to do. You only get one life, you got to live it. So this is the biggest one in Manchester, this graveyard. Absolutely massive. It'll take me about 3 or 4 hours to walk around it. Oh, that one there. Four. Daughter there, supposed to have died age four. So when your time is up, you get put in that little box forever. That's how deep you go. Right there. That's how deep you go. You end up in a hole like that. Big grave. Anyway, my battery's going. I'll see you in a bit. Graveyard lovers.